In the last video, we backed up the ODB57 Employee Search Form Part 2 tables into CSV files that we have right here. Now we want to populate the MySQL search form table with this data. I'm going to open up the MySQL Workbench, double-clicking. I'm clicking on the local instance, MySQL 56, typing in my password, and I'm going to paste in some SQL, Control V. That's a little small. I'm going to go into Edit, Preferences, and under Fonts and Colors, I'm going to change this SQL editor to be 14. We don't see any change because we need to close and reopen the MySQL Workbench for our change to take place. Here we see our SQL a little larger. We're going to load data local in file, which means load from this computer. The file name is in C users, the frugal computer guy desktop, table underscore department dot CSV. That file is right here. Then we're saying load this into table MySQL search form dot table department. Here's our MySQL search form database. Going into tables, here we see TBL underscore department. And then we've got fields terminated by and lines terminated by. These are just the defaults that we had when we created the CSV files. I will click on the lightning bolt to run the SQL. And here we see we've got the time, the action, that is basically our SQL that we're running, message and duration. We want to see this message a little better. We see 7 rows affected, records 7, deleted 0, skipped 0, and warning 0. The important thing to remember is the 7 goes with records and not deleted. To make sure this loaded up okay, I'm hovering over table department and I'm going to click on the table. And we can see our table right here was loaded up okay. So I'm coming back over to query 1. Our next table is employee phone. So I will change the table name to be this here, EMP underscore PHN, TBL EMP PHN, and I can see the name of the table right here, TBL underscore EMP PHN. And it's even showing me which table. I'm double clicking to bring that in. I'll run this. And again, we see our message, the rows that were affected. Here it's 77, deleted 0, skipped 0, warning 0. So that looks like that loaded in okay. Let's go to our next one, which should be the employees. Actually, I'm calling this table employee without the S. Employee.csv. And our table name here does have the S. Running the SQL. And here we see we've got some kind of warning. Says 27 rows affected, 22 warnings. When I hold my cursor over that, it pops up showing me the data truncated for columns, end date. So let's bring up that table. And looking in the end date, where it didn't have data, it forced in 000-00-00. That won't work for us. We're going to need to change that. So I'm going to need to open up another SQL window. I'm going to paste in some SQL. We're going to set SQL safe updates to 0. What that does is, well, I'm going to clear out my output area, right-clicking, and there's a clear at the bottom. You can't see it, but it's there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take off this first line and try and update our employee table. When I click this lightning bolt, we get an error. Error code, you are using safe update mode and you tried to update a table. Basically, the problem is there's this safe update mode so you don't accidentally update your data. I'm going to repaste this all in. So what we need to do is turn off this safe updates mode. And that's done by typing in set SQL safe updates equals 0. Now when I run this SQL, we see 0 rows affected. That's for this first line here. The second one is 22 rows affected, 22 matched, 22 changed. So now when I come over to the employees and click on this table, we see nulls for the dates instead of the zeros. I will close this and we're back in SQL1. I could probably close some of these other ones that we don't need. Here we set the date to null where it was 0. We don't need to save this. The employee table, don't need that anymore. And the department table, we don't need that. We've done the employee. Now we need to do the filter table. That is table filter.csv. Table filter. And our table name here is table TBL FILTER. Let's clear this out again. I'm going to lift this up so we can see it. Right click, clear, and bring this back down. Execute, and there we see one row affected, 0 deleted. The last one is group, GROUP. GROUP. Clicking the lightning bolt. And again, that table is populated. In the next video, we will look at creating relationships for our now populated tables.